Yeah, for the self-biased current source, we call that one as a constant GM, constant GM bias circuit. Yeah, see, we have two versions. One is a strong inversion version, and the other is a sub-threshold version. Okay. Then for the strong inversion circuit, let's just see, we have a resistor R there, then something like that, okay? If you put this diode connection to the left-hand side, then the loop gain will be larger than one. Doesn't work, okay? So for this circuit, see, if I connect this one into other circuit as a current mirror, then the GM of this transistor is proportional to 1 of R, this R, okay? Yeah, let's see. Yeah, in a strong inversion region, GM is, this is a strong inversion. GM is in a saturation region. Yeah, or something like that. Or maybe I can say in a saturation region, mu C aux W of L VGS minus VTH. Okay, this is a GM equation in a saturation region, strong inversion saturation region, okay? Then see, for those two transistors, gate source voltage are the same, right? Then, GM depends on W ratio. Okay, so for example, see, this is M1, this is M3. Then, what's the GM of M3? Yeah, that's W of L dependence, right? Because GM, we need to, this should be 4 to 1. So it's independent of current, right? So it's just proportional to 1 of R. So that's why we call it constant GM bias circuit. Yeah, let's move to the sub-threshold region. In the sub-threshold, you know, GM is just ID of NVT. Let's see, can I write it down as VGS minus VTH? Let's see. My ID is only, I can say, this is my ID equal mu C aux W of L VT square 2 square root 2 pi f minus VBS times exponential VGS minus VTH of NVT, okay? Yeah, you don't need to write it down because all will be posted in the homepage. Oh, okay. So, yeah, it has some exponential dependence, okay? It has actually same, let me see. Oh yeah, should be like that. Yeah, if this W ratio is 4:1, yeah, we found the voltage drop across the resistor is just MVT log 4. Okay. Then, what's the GM of this this M1 transistor? Yeah. So, let's just see. Yeah, this GM of M1 transistor is GM1, just ID, I divided by MVT, right? The current will be the same by this PMOS current mirror. Then, yeah, I know IR voltage drop here. So I divided by MVT will be 1 over R. Now log 4, right? Log 4. So if I have a parallel transistor M3 here, then this they connected together, this M3. What's a GM3? Yeah, that GM3 is GM3 is just ID3 divided by MVT. If M3 works in the sub threshold, okay. Then this ID3, they have the same gate source voltage, right? M1 and the M3 have the same gate source voltage. Then it depends on W of L ratio, right? So this is W of L 3 divided by W of L 1 times GM1. Okay? Yeah, it is proportional to 1 of R. So it is also constant GM bias circuit. Question? Okay, the question is how come, where does this come from? Actually, we did it at the last class, right? Okay, let me review. Any questions welcomed. So, you know, that PMOS current mirror, because the ratio is 1:1, and then this is 4:1 W of ratio, and then this is R. You know, current the same current flows through because W of ratio is 1:1 for the PMOS current mirror. Then let's just see, this is M2 and M1. Yeah, gate source voltage of M2 plus IR equal VGS1 because of KVL. Then the current, you know, the M2 current, I for M2, this is, you know, we write that sub-threshold current equation. We write the current equation for M1. What's the difference? So I will assume this drain source voltage is large enough. So drain source voltage is larger than 3 VT. So this term is zero. Okay? Then they should be the same. Okay? Yeah, then what is it? So this W of L is 4. This M1 W of L is 1, right? So 4 times exponential VGS 2 minus VTH of MVT is 1 times exponential VGS 1 minus VTH of MVT. I assume the same threshold voltage for M1 and M2, okay? Then, yeah, if you take a log of this, then see VGS1 minus VGS2 equal log 4. VT log 4. This is nothing but that IR drop, okay? Because of this equation, right? So IR drop is MVT log 4. Okay? Question.
Why we must set the M2 is the DOE for M2, M, N1? Why we should set the two equal 4, 1?
Okay. So your question is why you choose this 4 to 1?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. In this design, we put 4 to 1 because that's a kind of a convention for the strong inversion case. For the strong inversion case, it's very compact if I put 4 to 1. Then the GM is just. In that case, for the strong inversion, if I make this 4 to 1, those GMs are just 1 of R. There is a constant becomes 1 in a strong inversion case. But for the sub-threshold, we don't need to 4 to 1. I can make it just 10 to 1, okay? No problem. But this should be larger than 1 anyway, right? Should be larger than 1. So then this log 4 becomes log 10, okay? Yeah.
If I change the value of the resistor, I increase the resistor or the degree, what's the effect in this case?
Oh, you mean your question is what's the effect of this resistance value?
Yeah.
Let's see. Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, the voltage drop across this resistor. Voltage drop is only MVT log 4, right? For the 4 to 1 case. If I increase R, current will be reduced. I will be reduced, right? Also, you know, those GM will be reduced also. You know, say if I plug out all those GMs, GM will be reduced. GM is proportional to, yeah. Current is proportional to 1 of R. Yeah, GM is also proportional to 1 of R, right? So if I increase R, the current will be reduced. Also GM. Okay, yeah, that's good. Yeah, any questions welcomed. Robert Saylor, you never asked the question, right? Any question? Not so far. Okay, we'll wait for your question. Okay, then let's move to this differential pair stop.